This is Brett Waltemath of the Headliner and Star Watch Media reporting from South Beach, Florida for the 2011 Miami International Film Festival. Okay, this is Brett Waltemath of the Headliner and Star Watch Media with Philipp Stölzl and Alexander Fehling. Of Goethe In Love. First of all, congratulations again on the film, gentlemen. Now, I want to talk about the premiere, and afterwards, you guys got a standing ovation for this film from an American audience here in Miami. Talk a little bit about that, for getting that kind of ovation from an American audience.
Oh, that was so wonderful. I mean, we even attended the performance itself, the show itself, and spent like the first 20 minutes there, and people really responded to all the jokes and the different colors the film has to offer. So I think that it was really, you know, the film encountered a very sensitive and openly minded audience here, which is actually I can just speak for myself, but it was just a great experience.
Alexander?
For me, it's exactly the same thing. It's actually my first time here to be in America, so I'm excited in general. And yesterday evening was very special, and I'm very grateful for this kind of reaction.
Now, is this the first city that the film is premiered in here in the United States?
Not really. I has been at the Palm Springs Festival. Yeah, that was a couple of. I don't know, once Venice Palm Springs, like in December or something. Exactly. So and I don't know, maybe it's going to some more festival. The release is planned for, I think, for June.
And was the reaction in Palm Springs very much the same as it was here in Miami?
I have no idea.
The one thing for for the United States and Americans is we get very much caught up in our own American cinema. And for me, it was such a pleasant surprise, being an fan of international cinema, to see that kind of standing ovation for a German film. What needs to change for international cinema to really come to the forefront here in the United States, in both your opinions?
That's hard to say. I mean, we, on the other side, we are the big fans of American independent cinema, so yeah, I think it's an attraction that works on both sides. I just feel, you know, knowing a lot of people that work in the industry here, it's such a box office related culture over here, and plus the group of people that is interested in more elaborate movies is so small and sort of focused to certain bigger cities that had that, you know, that they have this type of people. I'm amazed, very often I'm amazed, like what wonderful American movies do not get distribution, like domestic over here. So I think it's just hard to find in this market the audience. But then, on the other hand, you know, I feel like if you make a movie and you have something to say and it reaches a small amount of people, but that's the people you want to reach. That's okay, right? You don't measure the success of a movie purely by like how many millions did watch it or how much millions of dollars did it make.
Mm-hmm. Now, Alexander, as you said, in your first time here in the United States, how's this experience been for you? The Miami International Film Festival for both of you. How's the whole experience been for you in the United States and here in Miami?
I was to be honest with you, I was always waiting for a reason to come here, but because I didn't want to just travel around, I thought maybe sometimes yeah, and it's like that. It's really like that. It's a pleasure for me to speak English at least. I'm watching a lot of series from America and a lot of movies, and it's very exciting for me to come here and to talk with American people about movies and about our movie especially, as well. And it's just very exciting.
Philip, during the casting for the role of Goethe, it may be a little awkward because Alexander's right here, but What made Alexander really stand out for this role, and what really separated him from the other actors that were auditioning for the role?
Well, I guess if you cast a part like that, you lead, you know, it's the end. In the end, it's like a decision you make, like with your instinct, really. I mean, I was really lucky because Alexander was really the first one we auditioned, and I basically knew it after like a minute that he was the right guy. I mean, we tried some other guys after that just to be sure, but you know, basically I knew it right away. And he just fitted the part so perfectly. I think you can see the movie, and that's something I knew right away. I mean, I could now like tell you all the, you know, great talents he has and why he does fit the part, but I think the movie is very easy to see. And plus, you know, it's especially if you cast your leads, it's almost a bit like falling in love. Right, I think there's always this sort of love between the director and the actors. I mean, not in any like physical sense or whatever. No, it's just that, you know, you wanna, you know, they become the. You work on a screenplay, and it's very intimate work, and you spend like at least like 1 year or 2 years. You spend very closely with the characters. You make up your mind, you know. You write their lines, and then you develop an imagination how they might be, like the character might be. So it's something, you know, them actually before the actors come in, and suddenly there's someone walking in and make this character coming to life, and there's instantly, even if you don't know each other, there's like a moment between you, and either you, there's like this instinctive hit, you know, and you it's like falling in love with a girl, right? You just see, I saw him and it's like, okay, that's the guy.
Mm-hmm. Now, Alexander, in your character, we see a lot of kind of this very, I guess, happy-go-lucky, kind of goofy and fun personality come out in Guthan. Was that very natural for you? Because it really felt natural on screen, that was very much just a part of your personality coming out on screen. Is that true?
Yes, I think so. I think the only chance you have is take what you got, and what you don't have, you can't play, I think. Huh? It's I don't know, it's always... Oh, I'm sorry. Wasn't me. I gotta go.
He just got nominated last night. I mean, this morning, he got nominated for...
Thank you. I'm stuttering already. No, it's always I think you always have to find the it's difficult to say. You cut up something concerning your own personality, and you try to find these things that are fit in this character, and I'm just searching inside of myself. So that's all I have.
Now, Philipp, one thing about this film, without giving anything away, one thing that I thought was so that I absolutely loved about it were some of the just landscape shots, just some of the spots, just some of the locations that you shot from were absolutely beautiful. Which locations did you choose, and how long did it take you to find some of these locations?
Well, I mean, the movie required some prep, really. I mean, once you start, you know, you work on a screenplay, then you think about locations, and the first thing you realize, like shooting a movie set in the 18th century, it's almost like shooting a science fiction. Like there's no place you find that this works like just the way it is. You know, like you look at a landscape, there will be telephone, electricity, you know, some highway. You look at a city, and you travel to a city that has some old architecture, and you feel like, okay, the roofs are wrong, the paint is wrong, the pavement looked totally different. I mean, the problem, like with the 18th century, another, you know, congratulations. You have to win it first. you just nominate it. Don't get become a big head.
Your fault. It's your movie.
Well, if the, you know, and then you start. I mean, I come. You know, my father was a museum director, so I come. You know, come with a very broad historical knowledge, and you can very well research how cities looked at that time, how landscapes looked at that time. There's a lot of paintings that will tell you how it was, and then you have like this dream of how the movie might look like. You want these cities without pavement. You want the like almost romantic, untouched landscapes. And then that's really hard work. You know, you find you find an old city, and you okay, we remove this, we do a set design part in the foreground to hide the new telephone box, and then you'll remove some of the background with in CG and make some 3D churches in. And for the landscape, same. You know, it's like okay, let's go. Okay, we for the movie we shot at the triangle of the Poland, Czech Republic, and Germany. These three countries meet. And for the landscape shots, we went over to Poland because obviously there's less civilization there. But still is a couple of stuff to we had to retouch. Obviously, like for the phone, telephone poles, etc. So, but in the end, you know, this is really the part. I mean, of the movie that required a hell out of work, and that there's like the whole sequence where, for example, Alexander, he runs through that ancient city, then that opens the movie. The scene, that's all storyboarded, and it's really well. It's a very crafted piece of film.
Well, Alexander, I'll give the last question to you, especially since you're fresh off this nomination. You're playing it very cool right now for, you know, not even being 24 hours, you know, into your nomination. But how is that? It's got to be wonderful for you. You're giving more notoriety to your film and to yourself for the future, going into the future of your career. Really just, you know, how do you feel right now? And that?
No, it's wonderful. I mean, the first movie I did is like four years ago, and after that I was playing a lead, and after that I was playing more and more smaller parts in films that I liked or with directors that I admire, and I forced myself to be patient about finding a good character to play in, and it's sometimes you get offers of a lot of characters, and you never know if there's another offer coming after that, and so for me it's really kind of a relief, and I'm really satisfied about the fact that I was a bit patient, and now I'm getting much more chances, and it's a good time for me now, and I'm grateful for that.
As long as you say. Okay, we can do training. Okay, I'm Alexander Fehling. I'm so grateful for this award. I owe everything to my director.
What's his name again?
Please, Philipp, if you hear me, and some place.
No, Alexander, Philipp, congratulations to you both on an absolutely beautiful film. Congratulations on your nomination, and I wish you both much success in the future going into award season. Congratulations to you both.